टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ब्रेड्थ फर्स्ट सर्च। दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेरी पॉपुलर एल्गोरिथम इन कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इट हैज मेनी एप्लीकेशन एरियाज लाइक वी कैन अप्लाई इट फॉर फाइंडिंग द मिनिमम स्पैनिंग ट्री, क्राउलर्स इन सर्च इंजन। मे बी यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट द क्राउलर्स एंड सोशल नेटवर्किंग वेबसाइट। यू नो व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू लेट्स फाइंड आउट द सम फ्रेंड्स एट अ पर्टिकुलर डेप्थ, लेट्स डेप्थ के या डेप्थ के प्लस वन या मे बी वन आर टू, सो वी अप्लाई द ब्रेडथ फर्स्ट सर्च एल्गोरिथम देयर। एंड इफ वी लुक एट द नेटवर्किंग एरिया, सो वी कैन अप्लाई दिस ब्रेडथ फर्स्ट सर्च कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर ब्रॉडकास्टिंग द मैसेज। And similarly, if we are willing to find out the capacity of a network, then we apply there also, you know, this breadth first search algorithm. And when we are going to talk about the implementation of breadth first search, so it uses the queue concept. Queue, you all are aware, first in, first out. So it uses the queue concept to let's traverse the graph in breadth first search manner. So this is in the diagram. You can see these are the nodes connected with the edges, and if we are looking to let's traverse this graph using this breadth first search technique. So you can see in the traversal order is something like this. So what's going on in it? First, we are traversing this node A, and then B and C, and then after that D, E, F. So you can see A, B, C, D, E, F. So sometimes we call it, level order traversal also. Level order traversal also. Now, if you look at the traversal, so you can have a conclusion like, when we traversing the A, then we are traversing the B and C. So that means after traversing this node, we are traversing the next nodes which are at the same distance. Like, here, these are at the same distance, that is one. And similarly, these are the a distance two. So that means if we are visiting a node in the graph, and then when we are going to traverse the node at label K, let's label K, then we have to traverse all the nodes at label K from the let's node A, and then after that we'll move the label K plus one and so on till the end of the label. So this is the way of, I mean, this is the very fundamental way of traversing the graph, and I hope it is you all are aware. And it is not necessary that its answer will be this one only, because answer cannot be answer is not necessary to be unique. Because suppose that we are traversing A, and then before traversing B we are traversing, let's say, C and then B, and then after that maybe E and then F and then D. So this is also breadth first traversal. Similarly, you can change the order again, something like A, B, C, and maybe F, E, D. F, E, D. So this is also one of the breadth first search, or I mean, searching the nodes using this technique. So look at here the very fundamental concepts associated with breadth first search. Breadth first search is an algorithm for traversing or searching tree or graph data structure, and it starts at the root tree, a tree root. So it is not necessary that we are going to traverse the tree only. It can be graph also. It can be graph also. So maybe you are having the let's graph like this in the form of tree, or maybe sometimes it is connected like this, so it is a graph. And when we are not having this portion, then it is a tree. So this BFS is applicable for let's whether you are having the tree or whether you are having the graph, but of course it will start from a particular node, and we call that node as a root, and explores all the neighbors nodes at the present depth, prior to moving on the nodes at the next depth level. So suppose that here in this graph, these are the labels. So this is the, let's depth level maybe k, or you know k is equal to 1, and then here it is k plus 1, that is k is equal to maybe k plus 1 is equal to 2. So you can see here explore all the nodes at label, let's say at a particular label, before moving to the next label. So this is the let's say basic philosophy behind this algorithm. Now we can conclude this line like this: BFS discovers all the vertices at distance k from S. What is S? S is the source node. At distance k from S is a source node, before discovering any vertices at distance k plus 1. Now, third point, we have already discussed in the very beginning. BFS uses first in, first out concept, and it is implemented with the help of concept Q. So let me mention the few terms related to the implementation of breadth first search. So whatever the graph we will be having in this breadth first search, initially its color will be white when we are going to apply breadth first search. So initially its color we can consider as white, and then after let's say exploring it, it will become gray, and then let's come after completing the process, it will become black. And there are a few other structures, yeah, maybe arrays we have used, that is color, it is used to store the color of the node, as we have seen white, gray, black. So it can take three values, whether it will be white or gray or black, and this phi indicates the parent of this vertex v, parent of this vertex v. So suppose that this is your node S. If you are moving from S to this node X, then S is parent of this node X. So pi indicates the parent information of the node, and d indicates the distance of node u from where, from the source node. So du is used to store the distance of node u from source node. So here, if you are considering s as a source node, and let's say this is your node u, so if you are coming from here, so it will be updated like, let's, this is your node v and this is your node u. So distance will be updated like dv is equal to du plus 1. So whatever distance you are having at the source node from where you are moving to the next node, for calculating the distance of this node, it will be the summation of source node plus 1. So these are the concepts, concepts have been used in the breadth first search algorithm. And for explanation point of view, what we are going to do, we are going to use a notation like single circle will represent the node is white, and if we are having the double circle, then node will be gray, and the triple circle will be representing the node is black. So these are the notations will be used while explanation, so that we can explain here. And although in the book it is used with the color concept, and that's why white, gray, and black is used. So look at here. This is a graph given here. And as I have already mentioned that if circle is single, then it is representing the white color. That means color of the circle is white. And if we are having the double, circle, then it is representing the color gray. And triple one is representing the color black. So our ultimate objective is to traverse this graph with the help of this color concept. And in this graph, we are going to consider S as a source node. S as a source node. So that means we'll start from here. You can choose any node as a source node, but here first we are going to choose S as a source node. And if you want, we can choose some other nodes also after explaining the concept. Now look at here. For each vertex, you belong to VZ. So as you know that for explaining the, representing the graph, we require, some set of vertices and edges. Already someone has explained. So here for each vertex, you belong to VG. So that means this V is going to represent the set of vertices excluding S, excluding source vertex. Excluding source vertex. And then what we have to do for each vertices excluding this source vertex, we are going to give it a color white. So already I have assumed that if circle is represented, a node is represented with single circle, then its color is already white. And that is done already. Now look at here, du. Distance of these nodes is represented with infinity. So let's put here infinity, excluding S. So that means here we are not required to put infinity. Let's put it here, infinity. For all the vertices, we are going to put the distance infinity. Now pi u is nil. So that means initially, no vertices, none of the vertices will be having parent. So their parent is nil. These vertices are not having parent. And already I have explained that if you are having a node like this and moving from this node to this node, so if it is U and if it is V, then U will be the parent of V. Already I have explained. Now look at here. We have done the job from line number 1 to 4. We have done the job from line number 1 to 4, initializing with the color white, distance u infinity, and then parent nil. Now color of S, explicitly we are giving the color to node S, which is considered as source node here. Source node, that means traversal is going to begin from here. Color of S is gray. Look at here. I have used the notation, if it is gray, then there will be the double circle. So its color is gray. And what is the distance? Distance of S, it is zero. Distance of S is zero. And parent of S, as you can see that we are starting, S is a source node. So very first node or maybe source node cannot have any parent because we are going to begin from this node. Begin from this node. It is something like jaise Shraddha aur Manu se srishti start hui, to Shraddha aur Manu ke bare mein, ke parents ke bare mein aap nahi bata sakte. Jo thoda bahut history jante honge in sab cheezon ki, unko pata hoga. So here S is not having any parent. It is something like nil. Now we are using the using a variable q to represent it a q. It is representing a q. So let's, this is your q. this is your q, this is your q, and it can have some elements, right? It can have some elements. Now look at here, in qs, in qs, that means it is talking about insertion of a node in the queue. So here it is saying that insert the node s. So what we are going to do, we are going to insert this node into queue. We are going to insert this node into queue. Now look at line number 10, while q not equal to null, that means whether if q is having any element, it is not equal to null, then in the next step, what we have to do, dqq, dqq, that means let's take one of the element out from the queue. So only one element is there in the queue at this moment. So take it out, take this element out, and then find out adjacent node of u, adjacent node of u. So adjacent nodes of this node u. So this node u is nothing but it is s, and adjacent nodes of s r will be represented with v. So you can see adjacent nodes of s are, you know, this node r and w. These are the two adjacent nodes of s, and it will be represented with v. So you can represent like v belong to r and w for understanding point of view. So this is represented with v. Now for each v, that means for r and for w both, you know, do if color v is equal to white. So first we have to check whether the color of r and color of w is white or not. So this is single circle, you can see there is a single circle, so that means its color is white. Then what you have to do, change its color to gray. So these two you know, nodes color will be changed into gray. These two colors, I mean nodes color will be changed into gray. And now update the distance. So distance is initially what is infinity. Now what you have to do, dv is equal to du plus 1. So du, that means the node source node from the node we came to node r. So s is containing the distance 0. So dv, that means if we are talking about dr, so it will be ds plus 1. So ds is 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. So that means now it will have the distance 1. Similarly, if we are looking for dw, so it is also will have the distance ds plus 1. So it is also will be equal to 1. And parent, of course, we are going to do one by one, because for each, let's say, we belong to adjacent of u, but we you know, we have to do for all the adjacent you know, vertices. So that's why we are doing here it is 1 and here it is 1, and then set the parent of these nodes r and w as u. So if we are drawing the line like this, that means coming from S to R, it is indicating that S is the parent of R. Now here also set the parent of W also. So look at here, setting the parent of W also coming from S to W. Now in the next line, in Q, Q, V. So V is R and W. So what you have to do, you have to insert these two nodes. So maybe you will be thinking that whether we should insert R first or W first. So any one of them you can insert. So let's, here we are inserting W and then inserting R. And of course, you know, S is dequeued. So the node which has been taken out, we can let's cross it so that we can. It will be clear to us that this node is dequeued. Now look at here, For each, we belong to adjacent of you. After completing the operation for R and W, you will come out of this loop, and now this line will execute. So what we have to do, color of U is equal to black. So already I have explained that when we are going to represent a node with black color, then we will be having the three circles. So this S is now in the black color. Now, after executing the line number 18, again, we'll come to check this while loop Q. Now you can see Q is again not nil. It is having some element, and elements are W and R. Now take this W out, DQ, and then each adjacent of U, that means adjacent of W. So adjacent of W node are S, X, and T. These three nodes are adjacent of W. Now look at here. For each adjacent node, you have to check the color. So color of W, you know, color of adjacent nodes of W, that is S, T, and X. You can see color of S is not white. Color of S is not white, it is black. So for this node, the all this these all the operations, color V, gray, DV, and pi V, not going to execute because this condition is not true for the node S. Now look at for T and X. For T, this node, and this node, for T and X, color is white. Then what you have to do, you have to change their colors as gray. So let's change their color as gray. Change their color as gray and set the distance DV is equal to DU plus 1. So you are reaching to T and X from W. So if you are going to set the distance, let's DT and DX. So DT will be DW plus 1. Similarly, DX will be DW plus 1. And DW is nothing but it is 1. So 1 plus 1, it is going to be 2. Similarly, 1 plus 1, it is going to be 2. And parent of V, so parent of T and X, it is going to be W. So let's draw the line. It is going to be the parent of it. Now in Q V, so adjacent nodes are T and X. You know why we cannot in Q S? Because this is inside the this condition, color V is equal to white, and its color is not white. So that means you cannot in Q S. So you can in Q only T and X. So whether you are going to T take first T or T take first A, that is not going to create a difference. So let's have the T and let's have then X. And then color of U is equal to black. So currently this U is nothing but W. So change its color to black. Now again, look at the while loop. It is again go to the while loop, pop the next node R. Pop the next node R. Now look at the adjacent of R, S and V. S is not white, it is black. So forget about S. Go to the V, change its color to gray. Set it distance, you know, 1 plus 1, that is, you know, DR plus 1, that is 2. Set its parent, right? In Q, the node, so in Q, V, so V will come here and change the color of U. So its color will be changed, that is R, that is black. That is black. Now again, move to the while loop. So pop this node T and look at the adjacent nodes of T. So adjacent nodes of T are W, X, U. These three nodes are adjacent of T. Now you can see only U is white. Only U is white, and other nodes W and X are gray and black. This one is gray and this one is black. So you cannot process W and X, you can process U only. So here du is equal to dt plus 1, so 2 plus 1, it is going to be 3. It is going to be 3, and set its parent as t. Change and in q v, so this you know adjacent nodes node of t is u, so u will be inserted here, u will be inserted here, and change its color to black, so it will be changed into black color. Now look at the next node. Now pop x, you know, delete this node x, look at the adjacent of x, so adjacent here we have to change its color gray. Now here after deleting it x, look at the adjacent of x, it is w t u and y, except y, other nodes are having, other adjacent nodes are having either their color as gray or black, so we are not, you know, have to worry about the gray and black, we have to look for only white. Now this white node, its color will be changed into gray. And now set the distance, so dv is equal to du plus 1, so dv is this one and du is this one, so 2 plus 1 that is 3, and set it parents, so parents has been set here, and in qv, so y will be inserted here, y will be inserted here, and change its color to black, so its color will be changed into black. Now look at next node v, next node v, so pop the node v, look at the adjacent of v, adjacent of node v is r, its color is not white, so these lines will not execute, only this line will execute, so its color will be changed into black. Now pop the next node u, pop the next node u, and look at the adjacent of u, that is t, x and y, all nodes are not having any one of these nodes are not having any color white, so that means nothing to do, just change its color to black. Similarly for y, pop this y and check its adjacent nodes color, nothing, you know, nothing you are having as color, it's white, so what you have to do, you have to change its color to black, because these lines will not execute, these lines will not execute. Now again you can see q is not having any element, now q will become equal to null, so this condition will fail because q is going to be null. Now this is the termination of this algorithm, this is the termination of this algorithm, and you can see let's here, you know, from s r, so these, you know, double lines indicating the traversal of the graph with the you know BFS traversal of the graph, so let me draw the lines for representing that. This is the traversal of the graph, so this is about breadth first search, and this is one of the very beautiful algorithm which uses the color and distance concept to let's traverse the graph, and this, you know, parent indicates that how we are moving from, I mean which path we have followed to move from source node to the adjacent node, so this parent indicating that, you know, when we are talking about s, so w and r having s as a parent, similarly v is having r as a parent, and so on, so you can see the parent of these nodes, so this is the traversal, in fact breadth first traversal of the graph. And those who are having any confusion, you can look this diagram, it will be more clear to you. This is indicating the gray color, you know, this is indicating the color gray, and this one is black and white. You can see initially, you know, other nodes are white and S is gray. So this one is indicating the initialization, and initially only S was into the queue, and then after popping the S, you can see adjacent nodes are inserted. Adjacent nodes are inserted, that is W and R. Then after popping the W, you know, after popping the W, adjacent nodes are inserted, that is T and X. R was already there, so R, T, X. So you can see, we have explored these things in single graph in previous slide, but here many graphs have been used to explain it so that you can get it clearly. So this is about breadth first search, and when we talk about its time complexity, so let me talk about the number of required operations. So the operation of in queuing and dequeuing take order of one time. So that means if you are going to insert a node or maybe delete a node, only one operation is required for a particular node. So the total operations will be required as order of V, which is, you know, representing the number of vertices. Since the sum of lengths of all adjacency list is order of E, because we are going to explore the all the edges, I mean, we are able to find out the adjacent nodes with the help of edges only. So we have to explore the edges. So the total time spent in scanning adjacency list is something order of E, and overhead of initialization you have seen already. For each vertex excluding S, we have initialized as color white and distance infinity and something, you know, their parent as nil. So if you look at what we are going to do, we are going to explore all the vertices and corresponding to their edges. So overall total exploration will be for all the vertices and all the edges. So we can say that its time complexity will be linear in order, and it will be represented in terms of order of V plus E. So if you are going to represent in some other way, so maybe you can say it like something, you know, order of N. But of course, if someone is asking that what is the time complexity of this BFS technique, then you have to tell in terms of vertices and edges, in terms of vertices and edges only, and it will be order of V plus E. So this is all about breadth first search.